Hey everyone, Demon Knight here. So I've been testing things for my Splash Guide for TPS recently and found some really interesting but also really weird mechanics regarding some guns. So in this video I want to talk about what in my opinion are the top 6 most weird and complex guns in the pre-sequel. For this list I didn't just go by how many different effects the gun has, but also by how complicated the math behind it is and how well known the mechanics of it are. As number 6 I have the Kaneda's laser. This weapon isn't too complicated in terms of mechanics, but how those mechanics work exactly and how its damage is calculated is pretty weird. Basically it's locked to explosive and its rocket was replaced with the laser beam of a railgun, and it is able to score crits. However, it also has plus 100% launcher splash damage. So effectively it deals twice as much damage and 3 times as much damage on a critical hit. Now the weird thing about it is the way it interacts with Jack's skill Integrity. Integrity is worth a video on its own because its own mechanics are very complicated. Anyway, Integrity boosts your damage against enemies below 40% of their health. Usually this damage boost applies to all pure splash damage and all impact damage. Added splash sometimes gets boosted and sometimes it doesn't. The reason for that is unknown, but the Kaneda's laser's added splash does get boosted. However, for some reason the Kaneda's laser's impact damage, so its laser beam, doesn't get boosted by Integrity, and the reason for that is unknown as well. Perhaps it's just Integrity being a weird skill again, because the problem with added splash I just mentioned also only has to do with a single gun, being the party line. On number 5 I have the Torquemada. Unlike with the Kaneda's laser, its mechanics are known but they are pretty complex. It has a fixed spread pattern, plus 100% grenade splash damage, and when it hits a surface it spawns small flag projectiles. These projectiles do actually have 100% impact damage and can crit. After either hitting an enemy or after a certain time they explode with again plus 100% grenade splash damage. Since these projectiles are unlisted, each of them can get either 2/3 or 2/5 of the amp damage, depending on your prefix, because of the plus 100% splash they have. However, this requires your amp shield to be fully charged when the projectiles hit the enemy, and since there's no B shield in TPS, that can be difficult to achieve. So basically, the Torquemada works kinda like the Swordsplosion and Pimpernel in Borderlands 2, except that its extra projectiles don't spawn when you directly hit an enemy. On number 5 is the Boxy Gun. This gun has also been completely figured out, but just like the Torquemada, it has complex mechanics and it has many of them. So the Boxy Gun has decreased projectile speed, can't have a scav stock or grip, also can't have a Maliwan grip, and always comes in shock. It also always ricochets off of surfaces twice. When it ricochets, it has a chance to bounce towards a near enemy, just like Gage's Close Enough or Nisha's Trickshot, except that it doesn't lose any damage. And when it hits an enemy, it has a chance to ricochet towards another nearby enemy, just like Maya's Chain Reaction, Nisha's The Unforgiven or Gage's Nth Degree. When the gun is reloaded, it has a chance to instantly blow up in your face, depending on how many bullets are left in the mag. The more bullets are left, the higher the chance for it to instantly explode. The reload damage of the Boxy Gun is calculated exactly like any other TDO weapon, so it's base damage times the bullets left in the mag. The instant explosion deals 12.5% of its damage to you and 50% of its damage to enemies directly in front of you. And lastly, when it doesn't instantly explode, it has a chance of dealing 50% more damage. However, I wasn't able to get this to happen, so I can't actually confirm this. As number 3 I have the Logan's Gun. Its mechanics are kinda known, but still weird. The Logan's Gun is locked to fire and it deals pure launcher splash, however only 75% of the listed damage. When it hits a surface, it deals its launcher splash and causes 4 explosions. The first 3 explosions all deal 75% of the listed damage and the last one deals 150%. Since its base damage is pure splash, all of the explosions get amp damage even when the shield is depleted. The Logan's Gun penetrates enemies, however it won't always deal damage to the enemy it penetrates, specifically humanoid enemies seem to have very weird hitboxes. When it penetrates an enemy and hits that enemy, only the impact launcher splash will deal damage, so the very first 75% damage I named. The projectile then continues to travel until it hits a surface and then the explosions happen. So the Logan's gun is a massive headache, but it gets worse. Number 2 is the 2 scoops. This gun is again very weird and its mechanics are still a mystery. It's locked to cryo and has all parts fixed. It shoots 2 slow traveling ice projectiles. These projectiles can penetrate enemies, however they don't deal damage to the enemy while doing so, at least not the damage they should be doing, but more about that in a bit. The projectiles also kinda act like laser beams or certain other shotguns in the way that they change their direction if you're too close to the enemy. The way the penetration works is that the impact damage of the 2 scoops can never actually damage an enemy, only its splash damage. Once the projectiles hit a surface, they explode and deal 150% launcher splash of the listed damage. Even though both projectiles are listed on the weapon card, both splash instances receive full amp damage as long as the shield is charged on impact, so 3 times the amp damage in total. Why that is the case is unknown. While the projectiles are traveling, each of them spawns an area of effect launcher splash damage around them that deals 18% of the listed damage, so 36% if the enemy is in range of both of them. This area of effect damage doesn't receive any additive gun damage, including amp damage. And when the projectiles explode, they deal 3 damage ticks of this area of effect damage to the enemies in range. So you probably think that it can't get any worse than the 2 scoops, but there still is one gun that tops them all. The absolutely most confusing and headache-inducing gun in Borderlands the pre-sequel, the ZX-1. I have no idea how this gun's damage calculation works, so first let's talk about what is known about it. The ZX-1 is locked to fire and all of its parts are fixed. Once you hit an enemy, all following shots will home in on that enemy until the enemy dies or you reload. Now let's get to the weird part. The ZX-1 deals roughly 167.8% damage, so 2/3 more than what it says on the weapon card. Despite of what it says on the weapon card, the ZX-1 seems to have a very high chance to apply a damage over time effect, maybe even 100%. These effects sometimes have correct values and sometimes they're ticks of 1 damage. It also seems to have some kind of very small splash radius, because if the target is slightly missed but the shot hits the ground below or a wall near the enemy, it can still cause a damage over time but without actually damaging the enemy with the projectile. I would assume that this weapon has splash of plus 0% or something, if that's even possible. The ZX-1 also can score critical hits, but if it was pure splash it would still damage the enemy when missing it. Also, it always deals incendiary damage, even if you manually remove or change the element of it with GIP. But now to the weirdest part of this weapon. It doesn't get boosted by any additive gun damage, including amp shields, similar to the 2 scoops area of effect damage. I have absolutely no idea what the deal with this gun is, but I can safely say it's the weirdest gun I know. So those were my top 6 most weird and complex guns. The only explanation for the Kaneda's laser, 2 scoops and the ZX-1 I have is that there are multiple impact damage types. This could also explain the weird behavior of Integrity as well as No-Kill like Overkill and Immolate in Borderlands 2. I plan on making a video about those skills as well, by the way. Anyway, in case you're unfamiliar with anything I said about splash damage in this video, I will leave a link to my splash damage guides for both Borderlands 2 and the pre-sequel in the description below. I have also made a video for splash damage in Borderlands 2 and I plan on doing one for TPS. As always, thanks for watching and see ya everyone!